So you have to accept it.
They kill the people anyway. What they're doing is that they're killing the businesses. And there's a few more. When they're doing big projects, I have done a project that the chief executive said, I want a Chinese contractor. And why do you want a Chinese contractor? He says, have you seen a sekondi stadium? It was done well. Ghanaian contractor cannot do that. So I want a Chinese contractor. The first instance, a Ghanaian contractor won. We had to redo the evaluation because they wasted too much time. They had to re-tender the new evaluation, a Chinese contractor won. What we are doing is that we are killing the Ghanaian companies bit by bit. Because for now, they give us what we want. What happens tomorrow? For now, they say that and if we are increasing this electricity like that, the Chinese companies and things, they have big capital. They can handle it now. In future, when there are no Ghanaian contractors to compete, what will happen? We just come with any price and you have a choice. You have monopoly. So this is the problem. Again, we have 200,000 housing units coming. Already they've announced. The Koreans have come to do it. 200,000 housing units. I'm sure it will even change. They don't have China. Because 200,000 houses, it's huge. It's a region of $10 billion. Which country $10 billion will affect? Especially a country that's 24 million. It will affect us significantly. And that one will give the chunk of the UC part to the Koreans. And I hear that's that makes it even worse. It
means as I hear, guaranteed by the future of your money.
See, I mean that's even sad. So,
and in fact, what he is saying is that Ghana is like a big car that is really ready. The milk is ready. The owner is sitting under the tree sleeping. Anybody can come to the cow
and
milk it and go away. This is what the situation is in Ghana. I know of a Lebanese who came to this country with just $500 American. Today, he is remitting back to Lebanon about $100,000 every month.
And you know how to buy weapons.
Is there no intelligence in this country? If you went to an American shop now and you bought something about $3,000 and paid with cash, before you get to the parking lot, there'll be the FBI standing there waiting for you. Here, people come 500 cities, less than 2 years. He's remitting. What did he bring him? What is he doing? What is the source? Now, as some of our people in diaspora are complaining, well, two reasons already, the economy is low. They are not getting money, but they don't want to send money back home because there is reverse flow of capital, this foreign money.
Yes.
They get to Ghana, the next moment, they are at the airport going back. And the culprit in all this is the educated Ghanaian. When they read, it's not that they don't know. What we are saying here, we are not geniuses. They all know.
Yes, they know.
They all know. But for a little thing like, 100,000 houses in America for the children to live in and go to school, they are prepared to allow.
Yes.
100,000, less than 500,000.
But let me center a bit more on the CRC. To us understanding, you are more like a mobile unit.
Yes.
You don't have a headquarters in Sekondi.
No.
CRC does not have a headquarters in Sekondi.
No. It's a mobile unit working within a certain time within the region and using the NCC in particular and the assemblies as reference points or collecting points for submissions. And we.